Hey everybody, welcome back to the chop. That was my Arnold Schwarzenegger instead of my John Wayne. Alright guys, now it's time to do this other wing. I'm going to show you guys how I got this. That is just perfect right there. And you guys see that? I just set it on there and it's just perfect. Okay, all the way down. I'm going to show you how I got that perfect fit. Okay, this was just that piece I set my wing down on. And see, this is what makes this one kind of tricky. It's got a different angle to it instead of just being straight. You know? So we're going to take some double face tape. You guys just talk amongst yourselves for a minute. Take some double face tape. We're gonna go about halfway. Save some tape. Just some foam. So I bet you guys thought I was nuts when I told you I was going to be painting this airplane in next week. Shoot, here it is. I just got this Saturday. I didn't start on it until Saturday about 6 o'clock. And here it is Monday. And I'm about ready for glassing. I'm going to be ready for glassing tonight. I might even get some done. I'm kind of anxious to do a little fiberglass knot. I like doing that part. It's easy. I'm going to show you guys how to do it too. Okay, so I got my double face tape on there. Now we're just going to peel off the double part. It's just going to hold it in place. Make it a little bit easier. Doggone it. I cut a lot of squares out of this, and sometimes I just tend to do it on the roll. Okay, now you guys see that? Adjust that camera up a little bit. Now what I want to do is I want to stick it on there, but I want to leave this an eighth inch short. I'm going to stick it on there an eighth inch short. Just the thickness of my sheeting. Ah, now you can see where I'm going with this, can't you? Just make it perfect. Eighth inch short, eighth inch short. And then we're going to press it in place. Now, all we got to do, it's saying that flush. Oh, that's what that pop was, that little corner. No big deal. And our skin's going to hold it in place. You want to press too hard, they don't got to go very much. 60 grit, people. I'm going to put a new piece on there. Cut that faucet down, baby. And we want to get that flat, that same angle. Done with it. Let's just take it off and get rid of it. Bam, now I have this. Now I have this sanded. Perfect size. And that's just gonna fit just perfect. Alright. Now I'm gonna take my stick. I got it sanded. The ends, both ends. I already got that taken care of. Okay. Now I'm gonna take my plane. Put that bevel on there. I can tell how far deep I'm going by see where I'm hitting that other layer of plywood. Another layer of wood, and there you can see it. And the new razor blade will sure fit, works good. Now I'll just clean it up. I want to get a shout out to my buddy who sent that to me. Let him know it's appreciated. And I'm using them new blades, by golly. Okay. I got that down to not sharp, but almost. I can clean it up a little bit more a little later. Alright, now I need to glue it on. Show you guys how to do it. And now I need to lay this flat. Bam. This is just light slide. He kind of did his method a little different, but he used 64th ply, and I just done it like this a few times. What's easy for one person is not to, you know what I mean. Everyone has their way of doing things. Bam. Now, check this out. Oh, perfect fit. Just perfect. Yeah, looks good. Looks good to me. What you guys think? You know, is that not clicking easy or what? 10 minutes or less, baby. Bam, look at that. That's that one I just sanded. It's the perfect fit. Trim his edge off a little bit. Just in that corner. Oh, that's just beautiful. A little bit more. Oh yeah, that looks good. Look at that. You gotta see that. Man. Alright, people. This video is about over. But I'm gonna keep trucking away. Definitely gonna also clean up that edge like this. Love these planes. I love them. But I'm going to keep making some videos, people. We're going to get this Cougar built. What do you think, John? How's it looking? So we'll see you back in the shop. Same Bob time.